Yes, teams on 10 from the hallowed turf. What a lineup we've got. Paddy Cripps is on, Tommy Mitchell is on, Taylor Adams is on, and Christian Salem is on the couch. It's a beauty. Yes, indeed it is. Teams on 10, Nick Butler alongside the former Blue and John, and now just the podcast king of everything. Social media. Dilly, welcome back. Great to have you back on the couch. How was Nunu?
Good to be back, Nicky, my friend. Nunu was fantastic. I definitely missed you, but as you saw, I was working very hard up there and getting a lot done. I was scouting the Noosa Tigers, trying to find some more players for the Ardmona Cats. Obviously, we're going up there soon, and it'll be fantastic. But I did miss you.
Good. Did you go to the Big Pineapple? Did you go to the Crocodile World?
No. As I said, it was a work trip.
Okay. Well, we did miss having you here. Chloe Malloy was very good, though.
I heard the ratings were actually maybe rethink going on
another holiday in round six next year. But it's great to have you back because you just give me this lovely warm energy.
It's that youth.
Yeah, it is. What got your juices just brewing?
Yeah, over the week? Well, a lot. Having a gap from you was actually getting me fired up again just to come back to the show.
Yeah, okay, that's one. That's one.
Secondly was the Boomers, the Baby Boomers at Essendon. A week is a long time in football, Nicholas.
Yes.
And they were fantastic.
The Baby Bombers.
The Bombers. Yeah. We've been smashing them so much lately, I've been quite hard on them, but how good was this? As you said, a week is a long time. They've come back on Anzac Day and played dominant football. Yep. Darcy Parrish is not that young anymore. He's probably 24, 25. 42 possessions. Tipper, unbelievable, 5 goals. You've got a guy like Nick Cox running around who's 200-plus centimetres.
He's a freak, old Big Coxie.
Kicks at both feet. Mason Redmond, Kyle Langford. They've got a great list.
Can I stop you there? Is this a bit of a square up from you? Did I hear you pop the Bombers on radio earlier in the year and you said they were no good? And why does everyone bag Carlton? Because Essendon are no good. That's what you said.
I have no integrity. So don't listen to anything I say.
Okay. I like good square up.
Yeah.
You named everyone under 25 there, but they are very good. They're exciting. So well done, Bombers. Well, I've got two. Now, Mitch Duncan, I've got a bit of an unhealthy love affair with Mitch Duncan. It's man crush on steroids. It started with this. So last year when we rolled down at Geelong and everyone was in COVID misery and Mitch Duncan just decided to put on a skills display down at Magic Hand Car Wash there, and you covered him in sanitizer and he's having fun, and he just went whooshka straight into the tray. Now, that was supposed to be a challenge that took like a year and players weren't supposed to do it. And old Mitchie just showed that he's got an unbelievable skill. So I was man-crushing then.
25-4 and kicked one from 70.
You're ruining my juice. So
sorry.
When I'm watching the game on the week and getting round McCatter's and I see old Mitchie at half-time just pull out a mongrel from 60 and ride it through, I must say I had a bit of a mongrel. Can we say that? Can I say that?
No.
No,
I think so.
We'll edit that out. He is a beautifully talented player, and he got me juiced right up.
Let me just say, apparently I was speaking to Mitch. Now, you know I'm friends with Mitch, family, quite. Yep. We're family.
Yep.
And he was saying he got inspiration from that, from going down to Cardinia Park as a young kid, seeing a young 52 run around in the VFL twos. Trying to kick drop punts, but they'll keep coming off as torps.
Yes.
So he said, look, I'm going to try and channel my inner 52 tonight and do that. It was an ode to yourself.
You've brought some funnies back from Noosa. That's just very good. He's in good form. Right, a good one. Hey, now I've got another one too. So I'm the local footy. You played your 41 games and everyone loves you and all that stuff, but I played the local footy. You know, after I finished up at the Cats in the 52, went down and you don't get massages and you don't get a drink bottle with your number on it, and you do it hard in the local footy. Shane Harvey, Boomer's little bro, has kicked goal number 1,000 for North Heidelberg on the weekend. Have a look at this. This got me juiced right up. That's a lot of snags in local footy. So we'll watch it now. It's against Hurstbridge and old Shagger Harvey just goes bang and they get around him. He's a legend down there at the kennel.
Sure,
and Shane actually watches our show. So we've got a real Facebook ratings hotspot in North Heidelberg. They love us and we can beam him in right now. So old Harves, what do you think, son?
Hey, boys, Shane Harvey here, 1,000 goal kicker. Surely I'm the Furphy unbelievable moment this week. I mean, it doesn't get bigger than that, does it? Anyway, I've got to go. Time to kick more snags.
It goes some funnies from halves.
1,000 snags is unbelievable. You think Buddy's trying to do that now? Shane's done it.
Yeah, and not in the old, you know, we're going up to the Kyabraman district in a few weeks. You know, a few people kick some snags in that comp. This is a Northern Footy League. So on you, Shane-o.
Congratulations.
We'll get you some Furphies out there to the kennel at North Heidelberg and keep sending in your... Yes, you take a hanger or you kick a torp, but get it into us via the socials. We'll get on to that later.
I want other people's highlights, not yours.
Your Noosa trip has upset a few.
Corporate?
Your behaviour? Yeah, well, we're a sort of PG show and you had your dad bot out. Now, I mean, we can have a look at this sort of behaviour, but what exactly was this? Well, we spent about $2,000 getting you a crew.
The camera
you
was
You wound yourself
geez,
up. You
got, that. You see, got, that, see that back? That was a road map up to Noosa. There was little of them veins. And yeah.
What's happened to your bottom? Did you lose your bottom in the war or something? You used to have you just no squats. You're bottomless. Bottomless pit. Just like a letter. I've sent a letterbox with more bum than that.
Yeah. Wrap it up. We're getting the wrap up.
Anyway, it was good. And maybe we'll do another Noosa trip because you've come back in good form. I think you're going to be hosting the show within half an hour.
I think
time for a break. We've got lots more great stuff. Taylor Adams, the wounded pie, is going to chat to us exclusively. That's after the break. Teams on 10 is brought to you by Neds. Take it to the Neds level. Yes, welcome back to Teams on 10. Now, well, out the Pies just missing a couple of key players at the moment. And one of those is he's a reigning Copeland medal winner in Taylor Adams.
Tough as nails.
Yeah, their midfield's just looking a bit one-paced without him. Am I right?
Yeah, you're not wrong. Yeah, they're fantastic. He's a great player. And as you said, he's a massive leader and missing a lot of voice out in the field. So I'm sure once the Pies get him back, it'll be fantastic, but you actually got to hang out with him.
Well, I did. I heard he was down at the G tonight, and I got a little bit of an invite in the inbox. Ding! And they said, "Do you want to come and have a chat to Taylor Adams?" And I said, "Absolutely, I do." So we caught up with the great man. Well, Tay, the old ball magnets launch. We're not mucking around. This is NBA style, MCG, lights, camera, action.
Yeah, it's all happening down here, mate. We're all set up. Obviously, it's been a lot of work in progress, and Tommy's done a great job with his team to get this set up and. Tonight looks fantastic.
How exciting to have a business come to fruition, you know, when you're still in the mid part of your career.
Yeah, as I said, plenty of work. Bit of a dream for Tommy to put something like this together, and he's done a fantastic job. Yeah, it looks great. The feedback's been really positive, so tonight's exciting, and we're looking forward to seeing what happens in the next couple of weeks.
Right, you've got about 50 years to be a businessman, but we want to see you back playing footy. How's the knee? When are we going to see you back?
Probably about 5 or 6 weeks away. Progressing really well, feeling really positive about it. So, looking forward to hopefully having a run around outside next week without any restriction on my knee and without a brace on my knee. And then build up to return to play.
It must be killing you to not be able to help the boys when they're copping a bit of stick and the win loss is looking a bit ugly at the moment. How do you feel about it? Are things not as bad as they seem from in the inside?
Yeah, it's obviously frustrating that I can't be out there to play a role. Still doing as much as I can off the field to support the guys and, week to week, trying to have an influence on how we go out and how we play. We don't think we're too far away from being really competitive. Obviously, we've been in games for large chunks of the games, but falling away towards the end. So, something we need to clean up. But, we're relatively positive inside the footy club, given the win-loss ratio at the moment.
Geez, he's a big man, Taylor Adams, and there is no coincidence why you are an award-winning journalist.
Because of my waffly questions?
Just fantastic.
Okay. Well, you know what I like about Tay Adams, and down at the Ball Magnets launch, which was very good, and thank you for inviting us down. He wants to be the next Collingwood captain,
yeah.
and he says it.
I love that.
Yeah.
We don't say what we want enough, and in the US sports they do. They say what they want and they go for it. And Tay Adams is the same. He's just gone hard. He says, I want to be the next captain of Collingwood.
In about 10 seconds, because we're getting the white, am I a bit off with my love affair for Nathan Buckley? I think he's a great coach and they're playing for him. They're just not very good at the moment. Am I getting it wrong, or is Buckley a good coach?
I feel like they've lost a lot of cattle. Buckley seems like a fantastic coach. I don't know why they'd be reassessing that, especially at the moment there's no one really to be putting their hand up.
I agree. Very, very weird. They'll come good. Now, social media. We are a social media driven show. I struggled without you with this stuff.
At 10sport.au, as you can see, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you can all see it there.
And we thrive and survive, and the Facebook ratings just go when everyone's involved. So we're actually going to have to put... we're putting on a DM assistant because we're getting so many. It's hard to keep up. Ding, 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 ding. Okay, so we got a few this week. I'll start with this one.
Never yet to see one.
Betty loves footy. Hi, Dylan, Nick. I think that's the wrong way around, Betsy, first up. But I like the show, but please tell Nick to stop showing his boring highlights.
Yes.
Fair enough. I think Dill is great at talking about footy, but I think his true calling will be as the next Dr. Harry Cooper after I watch this.
G'day, guys. Dylan and Francesca Buckley here for Pet Stocks, a Human's Best Friend.
Wow. So there's you with a pooch, eh?
Well, see, Nick, the thing about you and I is you're a news breaking journalist, award winner, yeah?
Yes.
I have diversity. I do different things. I host, I podcast, I love pets, I love my family, I love going to Noosa.
Is there a big dollars in the pet gig?
It's not about the passion. It's about the passion. I love animals.
Dr. Chris Brown.
Yeah.
I mean, you've got...
Well, look, it's purpose. It's why you get out of bed, isn't it?
You're going to start sucking up to Dr. Chris Brown like you do Waleed and Carrie.
They're my friends. I actually met them today in the lift.
Busted you doing
it. Oh, they're my friends now.
You're a climber. Yeah. You're a climber.
Yeah, well, you got
to
do it.
All right, so good stuff. Well done to Betsy Loves Footy. And more highlights because we donate to charity. And when you're not that
well,
good...
You do because you play your highlights every
good,
week. And you're, yes.
When you're not very good... See, Paddy Cripps and those guys don't show their highlights because they're good. When you weren't much good, you show them. That's the rule of our show.
Mm.
Okay? Now, we've got another one. Okay, so we'll roll that now. This is from at Quartermain. You star, Leo Barry, you star! Okay, thought you'd enjoy this Atomic Falcon from Adelaide on the weekend. It's a lesson for young players to always take the mark in your hands, like I did during my stellar career for North Ringwood under-19s. Oh, good on you, Stephen. I was also wondering what happened to the Quartermain Cup. That was the best part of the show. Any chance of that making a comeback? So firstly, what do we got here? So we've got Connor Rosie having a bit of a ping and boom! Right in the old 3KZ. Have a look. Oh, no. What do you think about that? He's about as big as you, that kid. You think it's funny?
I don't. I think it's very dangerous and we shouldn't be doing that. I think that is what your young son, Ted, has got in his... It's going to be happening to him very soon, unfortunately. You're going to be the dad out there trying to develop his skills too early, just booting balls at him, the poor boy. So hopefully I'll step in and I'll talk to Mel and we'll get some things in place.
Okay, we'll do a bit of ball magnets and that sort of stuff. But that was a good on you, Quarters, a good support of our show, Quarters. I think he might want to be the host. I think he's waiting for me to go to Noosa and he'll slide in and then bring on all the big guys.
Well, I can answer the question why the Quartermain Cup isn't on, though.
Yes, okay.
Well, there was no competition for me. No, it was getting a bit silly.
That's not true.
And I was getting embarrassed for you.
That's just rubbish because I had some good moments, okay? And my people have been talking to the Quartermain Cup people and there's sponsors coming out our ear holes. So I've got some news as we look at a few highlights now of last year's hijinks.
Yep.
It's coming back. It is coming back.
You'd be
I'm
nervous.
Told.
You'd be nervous.
I've got the old bat phone to level six here, where the big managers are, and I'm told after the Ardmona Bushcats debacle, which is on May 29, when we go up there and play the top team, and that could be very embarrassing. After we get through that, the Quartermain Cup is back, so that is fantastic. I'm getting the wind. I need to take a deep breath. It's time for a break. Who's coming up
next? We have the great man, 5-year deal, and gee whiz, he's a fantastic player. Christian Salem's coming in the building. I'm excited.
This is Teams on 10. Stick with us. Teams on 10 is proudly brought to you by Furphy Refreshing Ale. Unbelievable. Yes, welcome back to Teams on 10. Well, the D's are flying and so too is this man. Christian Salem is with us. Great to have you on the couch, mate.
Thanks for having me.
He's on fire, Nick. He's hot.
He is hot. Your form is fantastic and the 5-year deal. Life just must be tickety-boo for you.
It's going all right. It helps when we're winning. But, yeah, obviously, sign a 5-year deal. Keep me at the club till I'm 31 now, so...
Nick, you've got to apologise to Sales before we even get into this, because poor Christian, he's signed this 5-year deal on, you know, because it's well deserved. He's in fantastic form, hasn't even got home to tell his mum and dad yet, and you've broken it to the Australia.
I did. I ran into Jake the Snake Connors, a great man, Paulie Connors, and he might have just given me the whisper that you'd signed a long one. I thought it was 4, and just put it out there, and it just went bunter with the Demons fans, and Tommy Morris and Tommy Brown and all those real newsbreakers were just quaking because I was Carl Malone, the mailman, because it happened the next day. So well done.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Now, can we get straight to the big elephant in the room, the old Checker Hughes? Now, I think you were robbed. You just had 39 of the most beautiful touches. When the MC was fumbling and bumbling around, we can take a look at it now, when this was going on.
The medal will tonight be presented by Jennifer Allen, granddaughter of the great Checker Hughes. Would you please join me? Well, I actually don't know who the winner is. I think I need to know the winner.
It's Petrarca. Maybe it should have been Salem. Did you just think I might have to get a speech going when, you know, poor old Bridget was having a bit of a mare?
To be honest, we couldn't even hear her. Okay. I think you can see from the footage, Christian just sort of got the old wave come walk forward and claimed it. So he could have it. I got the coffee machine. I'll roll with that.
39 possessions, Nick. I couldn't dream of that. It's unbelievable. One thing I want to know, though, when you're playing this game and obviously confidence high at the moment, you're able to do your thing, which you're doing so well. One of the best ball users in the comp. Who's those players that are helping you do your thing? I suppose you're obviously, your skill is attacking. Who's helping defend and cover your man, and who's those unrewarded players of the Demons at the moment?
Yeah, I think, you know, we worked very closely with the back six and back seven. You know, Jaden Hunt, I play high with him, and, you know, we've obviously brought in Trent Rivers, who's in his second year, and just allowing me to roam a bit. And, you know, every week boys have their turns. A couple of weeks ago it was Hunty. Three weeks ago was Riv. So we all take it in turns, and, you know, it was my day on the weekend, and, you know, you just got to keep rolling.
What's changed this year? Because we know, like, the Demons have been building for a while. There's been finals talk, and it seems to, you know, come down and up and form goes. You're 6-0.
Yeah.
Something's got to change this year. What's the mood like? And can you put it down to one thing?
No, not one thing. I think it's a whole collective of things. But just, you know, the hub was pretty disappointing for us the way it finished. We had a chance to play finals, and we obviously blew it up in Cairns. We lost a couple of easy games, and, you know, we sat down at the end of the year and reviewed, you know, not only play performance but coaching, you know, the way we structure up and all that sort of stuff. And, you know, the coaches, credit to them, they went away in the off season. You know, they put through a great plan, and just really to simplify it. You know what it's like. Boys work best when there's just simple instruction, go out and play. And, you know, that's what we've done. And so far we are 6-0, but, you know, at the same time, you know, we haven't done too much yet. Still early days.
I know you can't look too far ahead, and you can't be talking about flags in April, but how much belief do you get from Saturday night? Because they were all over you early. And not only did you not panic, you came back and bullied them a little bit. It was reminding me a bit of the old Lee Matthews, the Predator. And if it bleeds, you can kill it. How does it sit with you now?
We had a lot of fumbles early, didn't we? So, you know, we knew they were going to come out hot, and it was a big game, and we had got a lot of young boys. And, you know, there's a lot of boys that haven't actually played in front of a big crowd before, because last year, Cozzy Pickett, Luke Jackson, Riv, you know, they had no crowd all in COVID. So, you know, for them to come out and just play their game, absorb a bit of pressure, like you said, you know, it's a credit to us. It just shows maturity throughout the group.
Blokes like Cozzy, you feel like he actually lives with the crowd now. He's unbelievable to watch. You say then, you must take incredible confidence out of coming with that. As you said, didn't start well, you come good and beat a great team. This week, massive test. I actually think this is a really big test, because you're coming up against a team that isn't great, but do you keep going well, or do you get complacent? Like, has that been something
Absolutely.
That's been...
You know, that's been a challenge in the past. Yeah. You know, we don't shy away from that, but, you know, it really will show the maturity in the group. And, you know, we had a bit of a interrupted week in terms of we didn't know where we're playing and what that, you know, we're flying to Tassie on the day of the game. And, you know, it's a good chance for us. Like you said, you'll see on the weekend how we prove it to ourselves and just come out and play. It's no different. Richmond, North Melbourne, you've got to be at your best, otherwise teams will knock you off.
I've got one, and I don't know if this is right or not, but your feathers are fantastic. They're just sort of blonde and doing plenty. Is that a passion of yours, the feather work? Are you a bit of a barber?
I was in the hub, and the colour was actually a COVID job, and I've just rolled with it. So I'll hold on to that. But I'm still trying to work out who broke my clippers in the hub. And I reckon it was Petrarca because I lent it to him for about 2 weeks for the beard. Got it back at the end of the hub and I was missing like two or three blades and it was all smashed up. So can't put my finger on it.
We'll sort that.
You're not a superstitious man. You're not going to roll with the blonde until, yeah, if you did get knocked over and then you'll shave it or something?
Nah, I'm not like that. There was something happened on a couple of weeks ago. One of the boys, I think, got injured at training. New boots, new mouth guard, like the full works. You know how it is. Like, there's some boys that are really superstitious, but just sort of roll with it.
I actually used to try that with superstitions. I'd be so paranoid about getting one that I'd just try and change everything every week.
Yeah. But it does work.
Didn't work for me.
Hey, our good supporters here at Furphy Refreshing Ale, unbelievable. They're all about the unbelievable tales in footy. And you've got an unbelievable assistant coach or development coach there in Mark Williams. I want to ask you a little bit about him in a moment. But first, let's hear about this Furphy Unbelievable Tales. It's a great promotion. It's a great competition. Let's hear about it.
Teams on 10's great mates Furphy have an excellent competition on at the moment where they want you to head to furphyunbelievable.com and share your tall tales. Those kind of stories that get a little bit bigger each time you tell them. So head over there, furphyunbelievable.com, share your tall tale, and they'll take care of the rest.
So there we go. Thank you, Reesey. Tall tales, Christian. I had a really good, it was a kind of boring Shane Mumford story a few weeks ago where I got a bit physical with Mummy. And
I fell asleep.
It didn't end too well for me. You don't get physical with Mummy. Mark Williams, he is a madman. He's been doing mad things for 20 years at all sorts of clubs. Has he done anything funky or unbelievable in the last few weeks?
He has. You know, we just came back off 3 days off after the Richmond game and walked out to the back of the oval and I see a big crane. I'm like, what the hell is going on here? So anyways, you know, just a normal swing. It's got all the things, you got to carry it in and whatever. And he's dropped the swing in. There's no swing. It's a boxing bag that's hanging for ground balls. So he's lifted up, very heavy bag, and just slam it into you. I practice your ground balls. And he's trying to take us through some fend-offs and shake the tackle, these sort of drills. So
how big is this crane?
It was decent. You had to get it over.
Is it in the building?
No, it was on the other side of the building. That the hook, the swing over, drop it in into Casey Fields.
Like a demolition ball sort of thing.
Something like that. I don't know what he's trying to roll with, but we haven't actually had a session on it yet. He was trying to show a few of the boys and quite a few kept walking, so we'll see what happens.
I've seen Richmond do this on the swing, but get a crane in is excessive.
I was in tears. It was
that is unbelievable.
It's one of many Choco stories.
He's not all there, is he? But he is there.
That's the best way to put it.
He's a genius.
He is there, but he isn't.
It is unbelievable. Mate, quickly tell us about your brother. He's absolutely dominating Brighton. Rock Salt, North Point. I'm a North Sider. I'm not welcome in Brighton, but would I be allowed at these two cafes?
You'll be our number one customer. We'll get you down there for sure. So they've been pretty busy at the moment, so we'll make room for you.
Hey, we like that. We might even add them to the prize pack. Well, great to have you, mate. I'm wrapped for your 5-year. Thanks for letting me break it, because I don't break many stories. I'm not very good at that sort of stuff. I'm more just like getting around the boys. But for being on our show tonight, you get the best prize pack in footy. So I'll run through this now. Christian, you get the 1-year unlimited wash club membership at participating locations thanks to Magic Hand Car Wash. Magic Wash Club's cleaner, safer and faster. You get a power drill thanks to Icon Construction and New Icon, a $50 breakfast voucher at Cheeky Monkey Cafe in Swan Street, a 101 Pilates session, Motion Health, Turak, a slab of Furphy, refreshing ale, unbelievable. The neighbour seller Shiraz, and we've got some Smash It hair product, which is very nice for the feathers. How about that?
Love it. Thank you, guys.
Dominic, thanks so much for
coming. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Nailed it.
Hey, there we go. Great to have Christian on. Now, our comeback to the big time in Ardmona is only 4 or 5 weeks away. Yes. We've been doing a little bit of physical work. That hasn't been going too well.
No.
Are you pulling up sore?
I don't want to do it.
Well, we sort of have to do it because they're all getting round us up at Shepparton. So I think if we're going to get a few kicks, it's all about clean hands. So we've decided to go and crash the old ball magnets launch and take the footies and see what we can learn off some absolute stars. Well, Tommy Mitchell, you have turned on a show. This is an NBA-style glitterazzi kind of launch.
Is it a bit much?
No, it's not.
I should have rolled in with the sunnies, the necklace, the briefcase. That's how they do it over there, isn't it?
They do.
Yeah, that's not really my go, so I'm probably a bit overdressed, to be honest, but that's all right, one off.
I like the wheels. This is a bit of LeBron. Who inspired the kit?
I don't know what that is. It was actually Tessa's idea. So Tessa's the PR manager for the event, and she thought the sneakers option was the right one for tonight. So a bit out of my comfort zone, but happy to give it a go.
I think you're pulling it off. In all seriousness, pretty exciting. You're launching a business in the prime of your career.
Yeah, it is exciting. Never thought something like this would happen. It's a childhood dream, let alone to play on the MCG, and now to be standing here launching an app to help aspiring footballers and any footballer be their best. I never thought this would have happened.
Okay, one on the footy. That was a nice tight win on the weekend. The old Hawkers are right up and about.
Yeah, I don't know if we're right up and about. It was good to get away with a win though. They were the Crows were kicking pretty straight as you, 15 straight at one point I think it was. So yeah, we had to stem the flow and we did in the second half. So we got away with one and hopefully we can keep building now.
Beautiful. You should be very proud of the launch. I've brought my balls to the ball magnet launch. I'm not here for exclusives. I'm here for hand skills, mate. What do you got?
We're gonna do some touch.
I do.
Alright. All day I dream of you. Butler's on in the pocket.
I'm on.
Get the legs, Butts.
So there we go. I don't know if we're going to be a great deal of help for the old Bushcats, but we'll do our best.
What have I told you about scaring the boys?
No, I didn't scare them. Oh. I think they liked my enthusiasm and that I just wanted to play and get involved.
Because the app is for like players that are making the AFL. It's not for sort of 37-year-old males.
One of these.
Yeah,
it's okay. I think they quite like me. Anyway, that was good. Thank you, boys, for being good sports. Hey, we better roll into the round 17.
We will.
Big,
sorry,
interesting round. So the Tigers and the Dogs to get us started.
Doggies, Billy, for me.
Pies and Suns. Come on, Bucks.
I'm going the Pies because I think they'll bounce back for Bucks.
Good to hear. Crows and Giants.
Giants.
St Kilda, Hawthorn.
Hawthorn.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh. Mm. Trouble at Moorabbin.
Yeah. I it's funny, you know, they said at the start of your top four team. I never quite bought into that, and I still think they're a good team, but not this year.
Fair enough. Lions, Port Adelaide.
Port. Adelaide.
Fair enough, yeah. Swans, Cats, and Jeremy just looking fantastic.
Isn't he? I'm going Geelong here, and there's a lot of history with them playing at the SCG too, so I think they'll win.
Now, you spoke about this game with Christian. North v the D's down in Tassie.
This is on for a game at Bloodstone Arena against North, who aren't travelling too well. This is a massive, massive game for the D's because, as Christian said, they've shown that they can come back against the ex-premiers, but can they have the maturity to play against a team that isn't going that well, but they'll want a scalp?
Yeah, I like it. Good summation. Excited about this one. Essendon Carlton, the game where you once celebrated a point.
No, I don't remember that. I've got to back the Blues here. Jeez, they've got to win this one.
And the derby over there, West Coast, very ordinary last week, need to bounce back.
They do, but I think Freo's got it.
OK, a couple of upsets there. Hey, that was Teams on 10. Bit scratchy, but we had some moments of brilliance, I thought. That was Teams on 10, as I said. Catch you next week. Get the footy in hurls. Thank you.